the mountains green, no stain yet on the moon was seen. No words were laid on stream or stone when Durin woke and walked alone.
He named the nameless hills and dells. He drank from yet untasted wells.
He stooped and looked in mirror and saw a crown of stars appear
as gems upon a silver thread above the shadows of his head.
The world was fair, the mountains tall, in elder days before the fall
of mighty kings in Argos throned and Gondolin, who now beyond the western seas have passed away. The world was fair in Durin's day. A king he was, on carven throne, in many pillared halls of stone, with golden roof and silver floor, and runes of power upon the door, the light of sun and star and moon in shining lamps of crystal hue,
and dimmed by cloud or shade of night, there shone forever fair and bright.
The hammer on the anvil smote,
their chisel clove and graver wrote,
their forged was blade and bound was hilt,
the delver mined, the mason built,
their barrel pearl and opal pale and metal wrought, like fish's mail, buckler and corse, that axe and sword, shining spears were laid in hoard.
Unwearied then were Durin's folk beneath the mountain's music woke.
The harpers harped, the minstrels sang, and at the gates the trumpets rang. The world is grey, the mountains old, the forge's fire is ashen cold. No harp is drum, no hammer falls, the darkness dwells in upon his tomb, in Moria, in Khazad-dûm.
But still the sunken stars appear in dark and endless Miramir.
Their light is crowning war.